For you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Thank you.
to offer prayer. I don't know why this thing won't act up on me tonight. Amen.
We're St. John.
All
right. The 14th chapter. All right. Praise the Lord.
Go ahead.
Come on.
Yeah.
Let not your heart be troubled.
Yeah.
You believe in God.
Yeah.
Believe also in me. In my Father's house of living.
Thank you. for them trusting us to come out here and do the right thing in the name of the Lord.
All right.
Pastor Coleman, thank you.
Yeah.
And our pastor, Pastor Barabino, very faithful. She get through with tonight, which is the 21st, is that right? She's going to rest for a couple of days, and she'll be starting up somewhere else, and when she gets to my, she'll tell you where she'll be. Y'all come on out. And let's lift up the name of Jesus. Bishop Hudson at this time.
Amen. Let's say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give them a hand. Amen. We thank God for the service. Amen. Thank God for the conducting of the service. Amen. God is an awesome God. He's more certainly worthy to be praised. Amen. We got a speaker for y'all tonight. Now, I know y'all thought I was going to preach. We got a speaker tonight. Amen. We got a speaker tonight.
Hallelujah.
We happy, amen, tonight to know. Amen. We're going to do a little song or two before we do it. But we happy tonight to know, amen, Pastor Kevin Lofton.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
The pastor of McAdoo Temple.
Yeah.
Amen. We thank God for him. We've been knowing each other for a lot of years.
Yeah.
Long time. Amen. He never changed. He never changed. Amen. So I invited him out to the big top tent. Amen. And he's here. Amen. So we appreciate he beat me here. Amen. So we thank God. We're going to do a couple of selections. We're going to be y'all choir for tonight. Amen. We're going to be y'all choir for tonight. Amen. And then we'll get ready to turn it over to amen, Pastor Lofton, so God can use it. Amen. I don't know what, and it just hit me coming here tonight. Amen. You see who under the tent, right? Amen. And some things gonna take place. The folk gonna be running to Jesus. Amen. They gonna be running to him. And let me tell you something. Some of them ain't gonna make it. I want you to know that some of them are not gonna make it. Amen. I want Kingston to hear this. Amen. This tent ain't here for 21 days for nothing. Amen. Some stuff finna take place. Amen. And you gonna wish that you came under this big top tent. Amen. You gonna be looking for the preacher. But guess what? It's gonna be too late. Amen. Somebody said, well, when is Jeremy Day? Jeremy Day whenever your time comes. That's when Jeremy Day. I'm not preaching tonight. Amen. Pastor Lawson preaching tonight. Amen. But we just want to encourage you tonight. Amen. You got gold right in your neighborhood and you're looking over it. Amen. You got ruby right in your neighborhood and you're looking over it. Amen. Already here. Blessing is hitting you all around and you're looking right over it. Amen. I look at these tents and look at them how they push the service. They neglect themselves to be here. So you can be saved, and you turn a deaf ear to it, amen, you're going to be damned.
Oh, yeah. All right. Amen. No.
I got to say. Amen. 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 Lord, he the lawyer now, he's pleading them cases. Just pleading one case after another. Pleading one case after another. But guess what? He gonna be sitting on the throne to be the judge. Amen. Let me do what we gonna do, because I feel like it tonight. Amen. I feel like it tonight. Amen. Amen. I look around and see what's happening. Amen. You better wake up, smell the coffee. It's brewing. Your coffee is brewing. Amen. The oven is hot. Amen. Amen. It is. Amen. I want Kingston to have it. Amen. Even after we leave here, there's a church right across the street from this tent, and it's open, waiting for somebody to be saved. Amen. All right. Let's do thunder. I think we got to do thunder. Thank you.
It's even heaven or hell in my book. That's the book I read the gospel. It's Holy Bible. heaven or hell, no in between. So if you think you can get into heaven going through purgatory, you won't get there. God already said we got to live right while we're on in this present world. I do have a word from you for you tonight.
All right.
Saturday while I was doing one sermon, I did two sermons, then I did three.
Uh-huh.
I worked all last week doing some work.
Yes,
sir. Saturday morning, I'm trying to remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy.
That's right.
I stay around the house and try to make sure I got the word of God so I can deliver to his people.
That's right.
So Sunday I did Father's Day.
Uh-huh.
I talked about Father.
Yeah.
I talked to MIA.
Uh-huh.
I talked to DVD.
Uh-huh.
Yes, the Father's. Are not fathers today like they were back in the day. And the men that are getting babies, they are not no father, they're just a dad.
That's a dad.
And that's a missing in action.
M.I.A.
And the DVD, deadbeat dad. They don't take care of their family. All that's going to meet them in the kingdom. Because if you not take care of your family, you're worse than an infidel. So the Bible is right, and I know it's right, and I know what it says. If you want to find yourself, get in the Word. It's in the Word of God. David said that our words have a hint in my heart that I might not sin against God.
Yeah.
So if you're not in the Word, then you're not with God.
Yeah.
But the Word of God is right. He said, for my word shall fail, heaven and earth gonna pass away.
Right.
So if I were you today, I get in the Word of God and say that.
Amen.
And you that already left church because of reason, I left church because of pandemic, I'm fear I might die, I go to church, somebody gonna contaminate me, and I find you at Walmart. You're at Walgreens, you're in the grocery store, you're at the park, you're doing your thing, and you tell me you can't go to church on Sunday. Well, keep on doing what you're doing. It's time for us to get right, church. That's my Sunday night time. Do you know what time it is? I'm going to the book of the Word of God. I'm going to, let me get my glasses. I had to buy a new set up there. I couldn't find no set there.
And the way it was
talking
yesterday, I found an old set.
Yes, sir. Yes,
I didn't need a rebound. I don't need to drive.
I got my eyes
worked
on, so I can see real.
Yeah, that's good. I'm going to read you what words.
That's good.
Yeah. Let's go to the book of Ecclesiastes. The 3rd chapter, 1-8. You'll find these words.
To everything there is a season
uh-huh.
and a time. To every purpose under the heavens. A time to be born, a time to die,
yes,
a time to plant,
come on.
A time to plug up that which is planted,
yes,
a time to kill, and a time to heal,
right.
A time to break down,
yes,
and a time to build up, a time to weep,
yes,
and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance,
yes,
a time to be cast away stone,
yes,
and a time to gather stones
all
together.
Right.
A time to embrace,
come on,
and a time to refrain from embracing.
Yes,
a time to get, and a time to lose.
Amen.
A time to keep, and a time to cast away.
Yes,
a time to rend, and a time to sow.
Yes,
and a time to keep silent, and a time to speak. A time to love,
right.
A time to hate. A time of war, a time of peace. These are the words concerning you about time. Do you know what time it is?
All right.
All right, I got to go to Romans, the 13th chapter.
Take it down, oh Lord.
And we're going to be reading at the 11th verse. And that knowing that the time that is now, it is high time to wake up out of sleep. But now is our salvation nearer than when we believe. The night is far spent.
Right.
The days is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the work of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. All right, thank God for that scripture. Let's go to Ephesians, the 5th chapter. And begin at the 14th verse.
All right.
We're talking about time now.
Time.
Wherefore he said, awake thou that sleepest, arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee life.
Yes.
Seeing then that ye walk circumspectly,
all right,
not as fools,
uh-huh.
but as wise,
wow.
redeeming the time, because the days are evil. And we know we're living in evil days. Wherefore, be ye not unwise, but understand that the will of the Lord is. And be not drunk with wine, wherein in excess, but filled with the Spirit. Speaking to yourself in psalm, in hymn, spiritual song, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. giving thanks always for all things unto God. And this the Father, and the Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Now these are the words concerning you. My thought to you tonight, do you know what time it is?
My God.
Do you know what time it is?
All right,
then. The time is winding up.
Yes,
sir. It's in the land, but God is still in the plan.
Yes.
Can't you see time is winding up?
Amen.
We hear wars and rumors of wars, earthquakes in Dallas places.
Yes,
people are running here and there. They're murdering, they're killing, they're destroying one another.
No.
And so we're living in a bad time.
Yes,
these are evil times.
Evil. But
we that are Christ-like, we need to make sure that we are on the right road. We're doing what is said in the book, in the book of Daniel, talk about that when you see the desolation and the abomination, you need to get in a stand in a holy place. Tonight I'm standing in a holy place.
Yes.
Sanctified, beautiful. You're in a holy place. Clap your hands. People of God, people all over the world, regardless of your race, people of color, people are looking at me right now because I'm all over the United States of America. I'm in fact, I got the biggest orchestra I ever had in my life. I've been in my church for about 38 years, preaching this gospel. We've been on the tent like this with Bishop Hudson, his wife, Sister Hudson. We have been on the tent revival, trying to tell somebody what it takes to be saved, what it takes to live right, what it takes to live holy. My Bible says, follow peace with all men, and holding thou with no man shall see the Lord. Now, I know we got men, we got women, we got males and females, and we got all kind of other folks. But if you think you're getting God's kingdom any way you are, you're lying.
All right.
No lie you're going to get in God's kingdom.
Yeah, all right.
He's all lies going to have their part in the lake.
That's what he said.
And there is a lake of fire.
Yes.
That burn with brimstone. So if you're not in Christ Jesus tonight, you need to get right with the church.
Amen.
Need to get right to go back to the church.
Yeah.
Because we're trying to redeem the time.
Yes, sir.
We don't spend a lot of time doing nothing.
There you go.
We are feeding our gums and feeding ourselves.
Right.
But we ain't coming to God.
Coming to God.
You know, it takes a word to save it. It takes a word to get you saved. We eat the food when we're at home. When we come to the house of God, that bread of heaven, feed us till we want no more. That's what I want. So we that are living right now, we need to redeem the time. We need to go back to where we first met Christ. When we first got saved, when we first got sanctified, when we first got filled with the Holy Ghost, we need to go back to the old landmark. Oh, I said the church ain't what it used to be. I've been in this church 38 years. I grew up in this church as a young fellow. And I know it ain't what it used to be. You got all kinds of people in the church, but they ain't got the church in them. The church got to be in you. You know, because it said, let this mind be in you. That was also in Christ Jesus, who walked out of the flesh but out of the spirit. A lot of got fleshly mind, but we don't have a spiritual mind.
Yes.
Amen. So if your heart is not right, you can't get into God's kingdom. And so it's all souls of mind, but the soul that's in it, it shall die. You got a part of time with death, the natural side. But there's going to be another resurrection. There's going to be another time when Jesus is going to come, sit on the throne, and he's going to judge all of us of what the word shall be. So do you know what time it is? I like Ephesians 5:14, the wherefore he said, awake, thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead. If you're dead, you need to get up and wake up. No, when Lazarus was in the tomb, he was dead for over 4 days. But Jesus went and resurrected him. He called the Lazarus come forth. And he came hopping in his grave clothes. And then he came out. And people seen what Jesus had done, they knew that he had worked a miracle.
Yes.
He's still that same miracle worker.
Yes.
That problem you have, that situation you have now, you know God has worked a miracle in your life every day. You don't realize it. Every day you wake up, it's a miracle. Some folks went to sleep last week. They didn't even wake up just that week. I told them, that's what I want to do when I leave this world. I just want to sleep away. I don't want to be a problem to my wife. I don't want to be a problem to my family. I don't want to be a problem to nobody. I just want to just sleep away. And when I wake up, I'm going, hey! I'm going to be in the hand of Jesus. Oh, I'm glad about it. See, I know where I am. I know whose I am. Because I got the Spirit of God under salvation. I've been saved. I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. I'm saved and I'm sanctified and I know it. Hey! I've been a sinner. I was a wreck and I did everything some of you out there doing. I used to party and all that good stuff. Drink all this boom boom and wine I could find. I didn't smoke cigarettes, so I thought seeing smoke getting with me. I didn't have no smokestack on my head. So I couldn't even bring it in, I couldn't blow it out. So I left that alone. If I you can do all this other stuff, don't smoke. Thank God I didn't smoke, don't want to smoke. Amen. But I think about the goodness of Jesus and what he's done to me. See, he brought me out of the club. I brought me out of danger, seen, unseen. I've been in the fire. I've been burned. 733, five people to the U.S. Steel fire back in 1980. By 9 o'clock that morning, I was in Lord Nolan Hospital. 733 on both legs. And while I was in there, I was there for 40 days and 40 nights. Tell me God say what's a miracle. Tell me God can't save. I don't care what you've been through, what you're going through. God can save you right now. If you humble yourself before the mighty hand of God, say, Lord, I want to be saved. He can save you. He said, who's ever called upon the name of the Lord? Tell me, saved. I called him, and that's why I'm saved. That's why I'm Holy Ghost still. But it's time for us to wake up out of our sleep. Wake up out of our sleep. And Christ said, give thee life. We need a life.
Yeah.
You know, I'm glad I thank God for the Alabama Power light tonight because I couldn't see this.
Yeah.
But the light in me is not of Alabama Power.
Right.
It comes from Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
He said, long as I'm in the world, I'm the light of the world.
Yeah. Downtown Birmingham,
okay.
And I looked up on that about the interstate. There was a gentleman laying up there, out in the open, outdoors, no food. He had on clothes, and I don't know if he was in his right, but he was laying up there. That's been you, you know. But God has been good to Israel, but he's been good to you. We got houses, we got land, and we got food, clothes, and shelter. And the weapon of the world is in our hands, but yet still we don't know Jesus.
Yeah,
God is trying to tell you it's time to get right.
Yeah.
It's later than we think.
Yeah.
It's almost midnight, and the Lord is soon to come.
Yeah.
Amen. So we need to learn how to not be in the Ephesians 5 says, it is a saint even to talk about things that ungodly people do in secret.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You got an ungodly people you talk to every day. I do. I'm trying to get them to see the light.
Yeah.
I'm trying to tell them about sin and what's going on in life. I'm trying to tell them what you're doing is wrong.
Uh-huh.
You lying, you cheating.
Yeah.
You're a homemonger, you're a backbiter. You going down to the club and enjoying yourself.
That's wrong.
Getting money and all that stuff you're doing. That ain't no God. How can you say you love the Lord and you're doing everything the world is doing?
Right.
He said, come out of the world. It's only the world being you. You know, we're not of the world. Our things are the world. So it's a shameful thing to be, do those things, secret things, nobody see you.
Yeah.
Behold, the eyes of the Lord is in every place. He sees the good and evil. He knows when we're right. He knows when we're wrong. So therefore, don't try to fool God. You fool me sometimes, not all the time. God knows that. He knows your thoughts will fall. He knows the number of hairs on your head. He knows your thoughts, what you think, what you think about, what you want to do. We got a lot of stuff in our head we want to do. And that ain't right either.
That ain't right.
He just throw that aside. He just think on the goodness of God. And that's what we ought to be doing. 5:13 talking about, but when the light shines on them, it becomes clear. When you're saying to God, you got the light. And I want to be clear. Others ought to see how you're leading your life, and they want to come and join with you. And when your light shines, it will expose the evil deeds than anybody. You got to have a light. If your light don't stand and help nobody else be saved, sanctified, and given the Holy Ghost, you ain't got much of a light. You know the story of the wise men, the wise men? They got oil and put in their lamp. I think it was five foolish. There you go. But guess what? Them that didn't bring no extra oil, they all ran out. And then when the bridegroom said, come, they turned on their lamp, they wouldn't burn. And others, they said, give us some of your oil. They said, no, we just got enough ourselves. You better go to the store and buy you some. Because we can't share this with you. And while it was gone, the bridegroom, when they looked up, it was too late. That's what's going to happen to a lot of us. It's going to be too late. When Jesus breaks the cloud and meets us in the middle, it's going to be too late. And then you're going to play the game, Who's going to blame for not living right? Who's going to blame for not doing what God says? And so we need to make sure that we are in the right frame mind. Because time is winding up. And so we need to wake up out of sleep. But Christ will come. And he will come and he wrecked us.
That's right.
Because Jesus is the light.
He's
the light of the world. And Jesus said, as long as I'm in the world, I'm the light of the world. Now I'm not going out of the world, you are the light. That's the light, yeah. Everywhere you go. Now that I've gone out of the world, you are the light, so let it shine. In your neighborhood, in your home. So let your little light shine. But men and the days are evil, so we need to make sure that some of us can see the good works in our life. May the work I've done speak for me. It seems like nothing at all. It seems so small. But the work you do down here, you're going to get a reward. Because
yes,
I want to say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter to the joy of the Lord.
Amen.
So we need to be that our light shine everywhere.
Everywhere.
In my neighborhood, in my church.
Yes.
Everywhere we go,
everywhere.
I'm going to let my little light shine. So people of God, thanks of the Most High God, let your light shine. That men will see what's good and what is evil. And then we can glorify the Father in heaven. It's time to wake up out of sleep, for our salvation is nearer than when we first believed. Wake up, people of God. Wake up, people of this world. Wake up. Your time is going near. And we don't know how long we're going to be on this earth. It's just a short day, 2 days. Men just a few days of what's going to come. Well, there's the rain. Thank God for the rain. Now, you got to get a man. But we don't under this gospel tent tonight. Back to the house, Lord, yes. But I tell you, it's time for you to return. Let us return back to God. He will return us. He said, if my people,
which
are called by my name,
come on,
will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and then turn from your wicked ways, I will heal them heaven. I will heal the land. We need the land to be healed today. And all we're going to heal, we got to come together.
Go ahead. Preach.
Let's come on back to that house of the Lord.
Preach.
Stop playing games with your life.
Yes, sir.
That I got a long time.
Go ahead, sir.
We don't have a long time on earth.
Amen.
Because we don't know when the Lord is coming.
Know when
he
said,
be also ready. You don't have to say the hour.
Amen.
He's the man coming.
That's right.
He's going to come an hour when we think not.
We think not.
You might be walking in the mall. You might be at breakfast table. You might be sleeping in the bed. And whenever Jesus comes, you need to be ready. You can't get ready.
Amen.
And don't worry about it. Let not your heart be troubled.
Yes.
You believe in God, believe also in me.
Yes.
He said, my Father's house are many mansions. And I go away to go find a place for you. And where I am also, you'll be also.
That's right.
He's already prepared a place for us. I told him yesterday, why worry about a mansion on earth when I got a heavenly place?
Yeah.
I got a mansion on earth. Tell me how many rooms in it. I'm worried about where would I spend eternity if Jesus come tomorrow. So I don't take no thought about tomorrow, because tomorrow's going to take care of itself.
Yeah.
Take no thought. Why worry when you can pray? We're worrying about the wrong thing. My life, my security, my safety, my income, and all of these things. But you ain't worried about your soul. What about your soul? Your soul is the most important thing in your life. If I die and lose my soul, it ain't nobody's fault but mine. Ain't nobody's fault but yours. You heard the word, and you seen the people of God, and you heard what they say. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Stop playing games with yourself.
Yeah.
Time is winding up. Destruction in the lane. But God's still in the place.
Yeah.
Can't you see time is winding up? I'm glad that I know what time it is. It's time to get back on our knees.
Right.
Time to pray and call on God. Lord, hear. Israel, when they got in trouble, they always went back to God. They got on knees, they began to cry to God. God heard their cry. And he'll hear your cry. But it's got to be a community, a body of baptized believers.
Yes,
getting on their knees, crying out to God.
Yes, sir.
We can save this whole community. Everybody come on out.
Yes,
everybody needs to be saved. Trouble is everywhere. In our communities, in our homes, all over the state, out of state.
Yes, sir.
Destruction is everywhere.
Yes, sir.
Earthquakes in Dallas place,
yeah.
Walls and rumors of walls.
Yeah.
So when you see the desolation spoken by the prophet Daniel, we need to get on the holy place.
Amen.
And the holy place is in God. Holiness is right.
Amen.
God was holy from the beginning. He being holy when he comes.
Yeah.
Make up your mind.
That's it.
Where you want to go.
That's it.
I done made up my mind. I want to go to heaven.
Yeah.
Don't want heaven in mind. Don't you want to go to heaven?
Amen.
There's peace in heaven. There's joy in heaven. There's glory in heaven. That's why I go to church, so I can praise the Lord. I lift up my voice like a trumpet sound. I cry out loud and fear not. I want somebody else to hear this gospel.
Yes, sir.
You let it out there in the world and all over Facebook.
Hallelujah.
Rest assured, we got to meet the Lord.
Right.
What time is it?
Time to get
right with God.
Right.
Time. That's what it's all about.
Right.
I hope I said something tonight to encourage you.
Good.
Get your life right tonight, because tomorrow may never come.
Amen.
Because we standing here tonight don't mean I'll be woke in the morning.
Uh-huh.
It is God's will whether we rise or not.
Right.
It is God's will whether we live or not.
Amen.
So I'm not worried about the things of life. I'm concerned about my soul. My soul means more than anything.
That's it.
And if your soul is not making it in Jesus, you are lost.
That's it.
He's on the way. He's out of the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. We come any other way, the thief and the robber. And no thief and robber will get in God's kingdom. I don't care who you are, where you went to school, what color you are, whatever the background you are. I don't care how long you've been teaching, preaching. If your soul is not right, you ain't going to go.
Amen.
He said, apart from me, you wasn't going to
live. Right.
Have your part in the lake.
Yeah.
Preachers going to hell until they get right.
Yes, sir.
I know too many of them ain't living right.
See that?
I know some ain't doing holy.
Uh-huh.
I know a lot of folks are not in God like they should.
Yes, sir.
But they got time, though they're prepping his body. Yeah. You got time to get right with God.
That's right.
Don't wait until you see Jesus coming. He's going to try to get right.
All
right,
it's late. Too late.
Amen.
Too late. So if you want to go back to heaven, just get right now, church. These revivals come for a reason. That somebody hear this gospel and be saved. And I wish we could have revivals under 10 every week, every night. You say you've been in 21 days.
Yep.
I hope the people in this area have heard the word. I'm sure they have heard the word. We all preach the word. So that's all we can do. Some plant, some water, but God get an increase. This word, God get an increase. He can fill that church up anytime he gets it. When you meet the condition, God can build it up. They'll come back to the church. But don't give up because people don't not doing what they used to do. They don't want ain't looking at that no church. You're not trying to get there. But my soul is hanging in Jesus. I find no fault in him. And I want him to say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter to the joy of the Lord. Because we got a right thing somewhere. Oh yeah. So I've learned to trust in the Lord with all of my heart. I'm not leaving my understanding. Because in all our ways and not as him, he shall direct your path. That's what's wrong. We leading our own path. We making our own way. But God said he is the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father except by him.
No man.
So let's prepare ourselves to meet you, God. Because time is up here. God bless you. I hope I said something to you. Amen.
My voice that don't know Jesus,
oh, yeah.
You can have him tonight.
Amen.
Amen. You can get it tonight.
Thank you.
If you want prayer tonight, you can come get prayer.
Oh,
yeah. Amen.
Tonight, I got a request. Amen. A friend of mine, evangelist Freddie Gilchrist.
All
right. Amen. She's an evangelist. And she's a friend of ours. Amen. She requested prayer tonight. Amen. She requested prayer. So, Paul's her name, Evangelist Gilchrist. We're going to pray for her tonight. Is that anyone else?
Bishop
Elder Bishop Elder Okay. Amen. Amen. Bless this house. Amen. God is your gonna be Pastor Mary Bear Field. Bless everybody else. Let's bless this house. Amen. Let's bless this house. Let's bless this house. Amen. Let's bless this house. Amen. That generator don't run off of nothing. It run off of gas. Amen. You take gas from that generator. Amen. I know because I got the same tent, same guy tent. Amen. I got a big generator. And I run. Amen. It costs to do it. Amen. So we're going to bless this house tonight. Amen. We ain't gonna forget about our sleeper for tonight. I want to bless this house.
All right. You got cash out?
Keep it, amen. I'm going to keep it.
Yeah, all right. Well, you, come on, Pastor. Tell him about that.
We're going to get it. Okay. We're going to be in his place, too.
Okay.
Yeah, amen. This year. We were there. Amen. We clowned out there. In that door of the temple. And say it better. Amen. I heard that. Amen. But we're going to be at his place too.
Okay.
This year.
Okay.
Amen.
Right.
Here we go. What we can do. Amen. Amen. That's right. All right. I'd like to say to the one that helped support this tonight, me, thank you. All y'all. Thank you. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. When you got some good music and good help, it makes a whole lot better. Amen. Makes a lot better when you got some good help. Amen. Good musicians, good preachers. It really helps. Amen. So I thank God for it. Amen. All right. Amen. I'm just trying to call all my avenues here. And thank God for Pastor Coleman. Thank God for him. Amen. Thank God for her. Amen. She made it possible. This is her land here.
Amen.
She made it possible for us to have. Amen. I just can't say it enough. Amen. Thank God for Pastor Manberry Bino and the Lord. Amen. Amen. They're keeping it going, brother. Keeping it going. That's right. So we thank God. Amen. Bishop, thank God for you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Good person. Don't want to quit seeing that. That's my baby daughter, you know. Amen. Now, if you tune in, she comes on Wednesday, Facebook, 7:30, every Wednesday. She's a Bible teacher. Amen. She teaches Hebrew and English. Amen. So on Wednesday, you tune her in. Amen. On Facebook, it's India the Voice. Amen. India the Voice. She come every Wednesday. Amen. Every Friday night, 7:30, Old CM Island J. Hudson.
Amen.
She every Friday night. What they're doing is they're reading the Bible. The Bible will be read twice in 1 year. She reading it from the front, and am I right? And she reading it from the back.
And then to Revelation.
Amen. Then, right. They're reading it back. They're going to pass these jokes. Amen. Reading the Bible. So listen at the word. They put it out there. Amen. On Sunday night, 7:30, and then you're truly. We do our church service.
Yeah.
It's the free gospel in every Sunday. An apostolic faith church. Come on every Sunday night at 7:30.
Right.
Amen. Every Sunday night. So just look to hear. Amen. We've been broadcasting from the studio. Thank God that Pastor Rose out of the studio last Sunday falls on the tent. So we just thank God for that. All right, this time I'm going to hush. Amen. And somebody said, what? Yeah, I'm going to hush. Amen. We're going to say amen for this Pastor Barry Mavina. Mary Mavina. Pastor Mary Mavina.
It's been real. Hallelujah. Can't wait for God to do that. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bishop, go get it in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We just had a beautiful time. So excited and so glad that our Pastor Valadino trusts us to come and help do this thing, you know. And I appreciate that. I appreciate the love that she has and the love that Pastor Coleman has. When I'm over here with the saints over here, I'm right with my folks.
All
when
right.
I need somebody to jump in and sing, need somebody to do a scripture of prayer and jump in and do it, and I just love that. When we get to heaven, y'all, we won't have to say bye no more.
Amen.
Amen. Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, we are Lady Evangelist Jones on in here and just here.
Okay. And say thank y'all for the love.
Oh, yeah.
Thank y'all so much.
All right.
Is it okay if you do this or you?
Speaker.
I love you, Al.
God bless you, people of God. We certainly let it lead on to tonight. People, first time seeing me, and my first time seeing you. So the people of this community, the Kingston area, have no fear, we'll be back.
All right.
Amen. Well, the spirit of the Lord is there's liberty. Yeah. We got liberty to come out here and just sing and praise God up under this gospel tent. And next time we want you to come over here where the table is spread, the feast of the Lord will be going on.
Right.
And so if you want to get some good joy in your soul and want to feel good and let the Holy Ghost rest through the body of your soul, right, you need to come on out here. Amen. Because that's where God is.
Yeah.
I thank God for teaching tonight. Thank God for you allowing me to come and speak the word of God to you tonight. And I tell you, it won't be my last time. I'm going to follow you all everywhere I am here. I'm coming. And I'm going to bring some people with me next time. Amen. Will you stand to your feet here and dismiss Miss Hudson and Sister Hudson and all the thanks of God, preachers and everybody. Eternal God, our Father, we just want to thank you, Lord, for this day and this hour. Thank you for this 21 days under this gospel tent. God, knowing that our coming be in vain, God, we let the word go forth, that it might not return to you, Lord. That every hearer heard it, they will seek you, Jesus, in every way. We have some bad days, we have some good days, but our good days outweigh our bad days. We not complaining, but we just want to say thank you, Lord. Thank for the revival, thank for the evangelists, thank for the speakers each night. And God, ask you to bless every church represented under this house tonight. Amen. God, just bless your people everywhere. Save those that are not saved. Give them a mind to be saved. Look on the husband. Look on the wife. Look on the children. Look on all those that are in special need right now. Send your blessing on all your people everywhere, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Now, Lord, we give you praise, honor, and glory. And keep us in the center of your will. Give us traveling and mercy to our homes and our destinations. And bring us back to appointed hour. All of these blessings we ask in Jesus' name. Let all the people say amen. 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 Bump somebody, head touch somebody, say, I love you, I'm glad to see you.
Love you, I'm glad to see you.